Okay, we have our guest here on my right, left on your screen is Bill Wright, and on my left, your right, as viewers, is Lindsey Nelson. Bill is from Withrow, correct, Bill?
Right, yep.
And Lindsey is from Stillwater, and what we're going to talk about is Save Our Schools, and there's going to be a website. Lindsey, you want to give out your website for people?
Yes, it's www.stopboldcold.org.
So stopboldcold.org. And so everything we talk about tonight, you can find that, or you can get hold of me and I can pass a message along. We didn't have anybody on hold yet, did we? Calls? Okay, let's keep going here. So you can call me. The number on the tip line there, 707-2282, and I can pass your phone number along and they can call you back. So let's start out. What is the issue? I know there's Stillwater wants to close three schools. What do we have going?
Okay, so the bold proposal was put forth by the superintendent Pontrelli and the administrators on December 17th, and it is proposing to close Withrow, Marine, and Oak Park Elementary Schools.
Okay, and those three schools are in the northern part of the school district.
Yep, Withrow and Marine are northern, and then Oak Park is central.
Okay, and so what is the reasoning, and we have some video to play in this regard, because I was over at the Matamidi School District last week, and you have a petition out there, but what's the reason, and what's the real reason?
That's a good question. The reason the superintendent and the district administrators are citing is fiscal efficiencies, fiscal responsibilities, more equitable distribution of student services and resources, and more equitable learning experiences.
Okay, but now the reality is, like in St. Paul, those schools, three schools, have higher Minnesota Comprehensive Assessment Achievement scores?
Correct. Withrow and Marine are both 5-star blue ribbon schools.
Okay.
They are in the rank top in the entire state, and Oak Park houses the GATE program, which is the gifted and talented program, and it is ranked 8th in the state.
Okay, so there's, folks, there's your reason right there. Remember in St. Paul, there were 4 schools that the Minnesota Comprehensive Assessment had those schools up in the 80% scores, where the other schools in St. Paul, so many of them, the ones that are named after failed politicians like Vento and Dayton and Wellstone and Obama, were down in the teens. And so you can't have this disparity like that. So of course, the way we're going to close the achievement gap is, in this case, we're going to close the high-performing schools, or we're going to lower the top, move to the lowest common denominator, and bring those schools down. I mean, that, folks, basic truth. And so, all right, so what are what's going to be done about this? The Save Our Schools, what's the approach to what's going on?
So right now we have a group of about 1,600 concerned parents and community members.
How many?
1,600.
1,600. Wow.
We have a petition out right now, and that's our numbers. We're above 1,600. We are working to meet with the superintendent, the administrators, the school board members, local legislators, anyone that will listen to our story, listen to our reasons. We have, you know, 60 years of national education, evidence-based, peer-reviewed studies that state this is not the correct answer. Small school consolidation really only stands to hurt all the students in the district.
And so people understand part of this, and Bill, maybe you want to touch on this.
Sure.
Uh, Stillwater now, under open enrollment, loses, what was the figure? 230 students to the Matamidi School District. 2.3 million that gets transferred from Stillwater to the Matamidi District. And Matamidi School District, people, you need to remember, one out of three students come from outside the district under open enrollment. The state average is 3 or 4%. Matamidi, 33%. And so they exist, and that whole school district is about only 3,000 students. Shares a lot of services with Stillwater, right? Lunch programs and some other services. And those three schools that you're talking about, they're close to Matamidi, correct?
I think geographically fairly close, yes. Mm-hmm.
And then the other discussion also is that the future growth is of students is going to come more from the Lake Elmo area?
That's the numbers that the district is sharing. I think, you know, as Lindsey was saying, the rationale is around enrollments and capacity issues, around equitable spend, and around access to services. And I think the argument from the district is when they look at future enrollment, that there could be, at least in their opinion, more of a population center down south, and the northern schools would not have as much enrollment. But as far as, you know, the numbers that we've been looking at and showing with the district, we can pretty much demonstrate that's not actually the case.
Mm-hmm. And so the way the 1,600 people want to approach this is to merge the two school districts.
It's been a topic of discussion. It's something that we're looking into as an alternative because, unfortunately, the administrators and the superintendent did not present any alternatives to this plan. There wasn't much community involvement in this, so it's fallen on our shoulders as parents and community members to look at and see what other feasible options there are.
So we have people like Chuck Wieger that I don't have much good to say about the man. He's the head of the state senator, head of the education committee, chair of the education committee. Now, he killed him and State Rep Peter Fisher. Those two were opposed and killed a bill that would limit open enrollment I think it was twice the state average. So in other words, instead of having these one out of three students open enrollment, state average, if it was 4%, the most you could have is 8% open enrollment, and this 2.3 million transfer, it would solve some of Stillwater's problems. If those students were staying home, those schools, the three that they want to close because of lack of open enrollment or lack of students, and their financial plight, because it's all being drained off by Matamidi, would that help the problem?
Well, I think, Bob, what you're highlighting is actually no one, if you talk to people in the administration, I don't think you get a clear idea for what will actually solve the problem. I'm not sure there is a clear understanding of the problem they're trying to solve. Mm-hmm. In terms of, you mentioned some of the open enrollment issues, which is a big thing. There's also charter schools that people are going to. Basically, parent choice is going on, and for some reason, the district has not been able to hold on to the students that they'd like. Now, you ask them why this particular proposal will solve it, and there's lots of good dialogue around that, but you know, I think we're not confident that this is actually the best option that's put forward to solve this, simply because I don't think they can articulately state what the problem is that they're trying to solve.
you can't solve it if you don't know what it is.
That's kind of our feeling, and that's why with the dialogue and the process, we're trying to, you know, as Lindsey was saying, engage with as many stakeholders as possible so that we can rally around. I think from our standpoint, we're asking for a partnership with the school district, mm-hmm. to say, hey, we're active and engaged parents. If you look at some of the success that these schools have had, it's because they have local community-based, right. involved parents that want to do the best. And, you know, there's a lot of conversation around equity and those types of things, and we're all for equity. I think no one here wants an educational system where there are winners and losers. Mm-hmm. I think we just challenge that closing your best schools is the way to drive equity. We think that there are solutions that could work, and as a parent body, we're trying to more actively engage with the administration and with the board to think through those things. I for myself, have yet to see an example where a school district closes down these types of schools, mm-hmm. and it's a net benefit for the entire population. I just haven't been able to find that example.
And what you were saying, the students that go to parochial schools, private schools, charter schools, home schools, I saw the number, and it was huge.
It's a big number. Right now in the district, we have what the district calls a capture rate, which is, you know,
72.
One way of talking. But right now we're a little over 70%. So 3 out of every 10 kids, mm-hmm. in the district are choosing to be educated outside of the traditional public school setting.
And I thought that number, what's the total number of students? So
we have 8,300 students in the district.
8,300. Mm-hmm. So if you have 30% are going out?
Yeah, so there's a they should have a little over 11,000 mm-hmm. students that are in the enrollment area, and about 30% of those students are going elsewhere, giving us to
the 8,300. So they're losing pretty near 3,000 students.
Yes.
Yeah.
Go ahead, Lindsey.
Well, the problem with the bold proposal is part of our parent group, we've released a survey, and our official numbers aren't back yet, but for parents that responded to the survey, about 60% said that they would pull their child out of the school district. And then that leads to this capture problem, this open enrollment, where you're taking students out of the district because they no longer are satisfied with their school options. So average, I think we found that the cost per pupil is about $10,000 or so. Now, when they close these schools and parents do decide to take their child out, that's $10,000 per child that will go outside of the Stillwater District, furthering their capture rate problem.
Yes, and so now when you have that problem, and then like you're saying, you close the three leading schools or three of the best schools, it's like in St. Paul. People start fleeing.
Correct.
It's a spiral, and this isn't to say, I mean, if you talk to members of the board and the administration, and, you know, we're trying to all discuss this in good faith, it's a complicated issue. I mean, you mm-hmm. highlight the open enrollment issue. It's a tough thing for a school district to deal with. The issue, though, is if you look at the history of how we've tried to solve this, there's not a long track record of success that this is the best option to go, right? And the fact that this option has been, this problem for the school district has been developing over several years, the fact that they want to propose this on December 17th and have it voted on and solved by February 11th is, in our opinion, a very hasty decision.
Well,
and the second point is, right now there's not even a plan to vote on, right? So the idea is we're going to close these three schools, but right now, they don't know what the new district boundaries would be. They don't know what the transportation situation will be. And they say that these things will be determined after the vote. But from a concerned parent standpoint,
sounds like yeah. Nancy Pelosi. Pass it, and then we'll find out what's in it.
Well, that's a little bit of the feeling. For myself as a concerned parent, let's have the discussion. I don't think this is the way to go. Even so, if you're going to go down this route, I personally would not vote yes or no on something if I didn't know what the exact plan was. And, you know, an example of maybe something that they're missing here is they talk about, well, the busing routes, and you could have potentially parents up in Marine that have their kids have a significantly long bus ride down to the Southern and Central, and they're working on bus routes. But one thing that they're not taking into account is that many of these parents, when they talk about access to mm-hmm. services, are using before and after care at these schools. So bus routes are the least of their concerns. They want a school that's nearby that they can have access to their kids before and after. You mentioned before, a lot of parents are working two jobs, it's two career households to make ends meet. And if you ask them what services they might prioritize, they might like some of these other things, but if they had to pick and choose, they want a school that's close to them. And I think our feeling is there can be sometimes a a feeling among administrators that they know what services you need. Mm-hmm. And there's not much discussion about, well, we understand that you want to give us those services, but again, if push comes to shove, I'd like a school that would be close by to me in my community versus having to put my kid on a bus for 30 minutes or have to drive the completely wrong way from where, you know, we have to work to be able to make this work. So I just think there's a lot of things that haven't been thought through effectively in order for us to actually even determine, number one, what the plan is, mm-hmm. and number two, whether it actually makes sense once you're to implement it.
See, part of the problem, and we're going to go to that video clip next. In October, the school board, the Stillwater School Board, voted to eliminate public comment from the school board meeting. Talk about closing down a system.
Yes. Yes.
I mean, it's like St. Paul schools when they eliminated public comment from the school board meetings. Folks, this is what's wrong with government. And then look at Maplewood. They've even taken it to the next step. They want to get rid of shows like this so you can't hear it at all. So the only message you're going to hear is the government message. Mm-hmm. And Pontrelli is out there in New York now learning how to implement and do more of this stuff.
Yes.
This is just a recipe for disaster. Let's play the first video clip that we have here. What do we have?
The school
district has these behind closed doors secret meetings with all the mayors of the school district. And, you know, I think we need to put out what cities are part of the school district. You have Matamidi, you have Hugo, you have Willerney, you have part of White Bear Lake, Lake Elmo, you have Grant, you have part of Pine Springs, you have Delwood, you have Birchwood. So these mayors get together with the superintendent. This one was over at the school district, and they forbid allowing cameras in there. So we're gonna show on Inside Insight later the superintendent over there and Tom Carr throwing the camera out that was there from you know, public cable television, throwing the cameraman out because they wanted to do these meetings in secret.
By the way, that's the third time that has happened. The first time,
All right, let's go right to the next video clip, or we're not gonna get through this stuff.
I was invited by the Grant City Council members.
He's not part of this, is he? The mayor's part of this.
The mayor's going to be here. I know at least one of the city council people are going to be here.
Why are you doing this?
Well, because superintendent. Now this is a meeting of the mayors and the superintendent, and I think that the public absolutely has a right to know what plans are being made in the district. I mean, there's taxpayers. And
don't let you. You're not welcome here, and you're being obnoxious about it. Why don't you leave?
No.
If you have any, you did not get an invitation.
What you're saying is not that Bob's not welcome here, is the public's not welcome here. The taxpayers are not welcome here. The citizens are not welcome here.
You can interpret it how you want. The fact is that you specifically are not welcome here.
It's the way...
You specifically are not.
I am here to get the information for the public. Now, if it's a matter of me leaving and the cameraman being here, that's fine. Now, I'll do that.
Thank you.
All right, that's good. We'll do that. I don't have an objection with that.
All right, there's more to that. That's where the cameraman, they throw the cameraman out too. That's how despicable, that's Mark Larson, the superintendent of Matamidi School. That is how they keep the public out. Let's play, skip to the piece over at Matamidi School where I presented the petition for combining the two schools. And then we're going to have a couple quick comments on that. While we're waiting for that, Bill, was there something you wanted to add in here?
Yeah, no, I just think, you know, revisiting some of our comments is, you know, one of the biggest things that is I was going to say an unknown, but not necessarily an unknown, is just the overall impact to communities from these types of school closures. Mm-hmm. You know, when we talk about education and successful outcomes, there's a lot of research that goes into it takes successful, involved communities to go after this. There's also a lot of research around what happens to these communities, particularly in rural communities, mm-hmm. when these types of things happen, when school closures happen. And you read some of these stories, it's traumatic, it shakes mm-hmm. up people's lives, and many times disproportionately on poor people mm-hmm. or people without as many means who don't have the types of choices. You know, some of us can make the choice and say, well, I'm not going to go along with this, I'm going to maybe choose something else. That option is not available to many people, mm-hmm. and those are the people that disproportionately suffer. And oftentimes the benefits to the communities that are promised are not realized. You know, if you look around to other school districts, Chicago, I was just reading an article about the Chicago school district. They've gone through traumatic school closures in their communities, and parents are asking, where's the benefits that you promised? You said there was going to be cuts. You said there was going to be benefits for, you know, from those cuts to programs, and they're not. They saw the cuts in terms of the schools, and they're not seeing the benefits.
Let's play the clip real quick. Can we get part of it in?
If you would state your name and where you live on my phone for the record. And
thank you. I am
welcome.
Bob Zick with financial and property interest in Montevideo. It's not necessary to give my address. What I want to speak to the board, good evening board, that this is a petition that is also being this evening presented at the Stillwater School District 834. And the petition reads as follows. Petition to form the Central Washington County School District.